because I would like this to be interactive. I have exactly an hour to talk to you and then I must leave, but you guys can always contact me afterwards. If we look at Livestock Fest, and we look at the first ever space that we find Livestock Fest to be a problem, and you guys can go on your Google search engines and you can go and search for the Code of Hammurabi, and you will find that this code, social justice code, was written before the Bible was written. And in section 8 of the Code of Hammurabi, you will find that people had the problem of stock theft. If you go further into the, you know, go from a biblical point of view, you will go into Genesis 30, and from verse 37 to 42, you will find the first indication that people mark their livestock, where Jacob and Laban had to share their stock, and they marked it to identify whose is whose. So that's the first point. And then when we go to the further in the Bible, and we go to Exodus 21, verse 37, we do find that the first ever punishment for any crime was for livestock theft. So it is just an indication to you out there is that livestock theft is not a new problem. It's not something new. It's always been there to such an extent that it was the first of the first of the first in about every social justice code. So that's where we are. If we look at the South African theme at the present moment, is if we look at livestock theft and we look at the seriousness of all the serious crime, we will find that in the past 6-7 years, this was a much larger table, you will see that livestock theft comprises around about 1.3-1.4% of crimes in South Africa. So from a criminal justice point of view, it's a very small section. It's a very small part of our problem is in livestock theft. But for us as farmers, and just for those of you who don't know, as I'm a farmer as well, so I do farm and I do understand it from a farmer's perspective as well, is that livestock theft is not only an economic crime, it's an emotional crime as well. Because with your cell phone, with your laptop, with whatever, you don't have an emotional bond with it. But when it gets to your livestock, you have an emotional bond with it. And when it's stolen or whatever the case might be, it is a double barrel effect on you as a human being. It's economic and emotional. So take it for that. When we look at the 1.3%, and I will get to the offenders and their profile a little bit later, you will find that in South Africa, about 1.4-1.5% of the inmates in our prisons is in prison for livestock theft. So then you can do your calculations. We have around about 150,000 and 160,000 people in our prisons currently. And we have about 1,600 to 1,700 prisoners in custody at the present moment for livestock theft. You go further, and you say we have 247 prisons in the country. It means, in short, that in every prison in this country, there's about 8 people that will be in there for livestock theft. That's just to give you a little bit of a background as to what we're working with. When we look at what happens to property-related crimes in South Africa, and this is a world tendency, that all property-related crimes is busy declining. There's specific reasons for this, but if you look at the dotted line, you will see that the primary axis is there's a decline in property-related crimes in South Africa, and then you will see that although we had a little bit of a rise in stock theft from 2015 to 2018 in the past 5 years, stock theft is also on the decline. And it's following the same tendency as all the other property-related crimes. And the reasons for that is we are getting much more technology, much more diligence. We have CCTV. We have all those kind of things. That's becoming more of a natural social thing in our daily lives. And that has an effect on property-related crimes. And we will get to that in the theories of crime a little bit later to see how these things work out. and for what reasons this happens. When we look at livestock theft and reported cases, if you look at the period, this comes from 1995. You must remember that we don't have any statistics before 1994. There's particular reasons. In this particular area here, you will see that there was a great rise in livestock theft. But don't confuse yourself there, because what happened is, with the incorporation of the old TB fee states back into South Africa, we saw there that all the stock theft related cases from the old Transkei, the Siskei, and all those were incorporated back into South African statistics, and it looks as if we had a big rise there, but there is a scientific declaration for that. And if you go through the whole graph, you will see that stock theft and the amount of stock stolen follows the same pattern as the sea swell. Oh, it's on the rise for 5-6 years, it's on the decline for 5-6 years. But if you see, we're currently in a decline from 2018. We are on a decline when you get to the number of stock stolen, as well as here with the number of cases, the blue ones here at the bottom. See, there's a little bit of a decline, but that's a tendency. It's a natural tendency. What we can deduct from this is that when the criminal justice system apprehends people, they put them in prisons, etc., they're out of the system for a while. We have a little bit of prevention, and when they get back, they start stealing again, and until they're caught again. But this is kind of like a tendency we see that can be predicted, and that's what we see from stock theft over the country, in the country. When we look at the province from 2012 until where we are today, and we look at the provinces and our stock theft measures there, you will find the two top ones here at the top. That is KwaZulu-Natal and Eastern Cape. They are the most prone to livestock theft, but the two provinces also differs from one another. KwaZulu-Natal, big problem with cattle theft. You look at the Eastern Cape, a big problem with sheep. So what you can deduct from this, that there's a little bit of a difference in the economic impact, because cattle is much more expensive than sheep. So that is the tendency line. When you get down here, you get look at the Western Cape, you will see that they don't have a lot of problems with stock theft. There is stock theft, but not as much as in the other provinces. We'll get to graphs that I'll show you what's going on there. If you just put this in another graph from last year, you will see that for 22-23, the year 23-24, you can see here that in the Eastern Cape, there's a big problem here with sheep. You can see that in KZN, we have a big problem here with cattle, more than in any one of the other provinces. When you get to the Free State, it's a little bit the same as the other provinces, but that's it for now. When we look at the hotspot stations in South Africa, where's the big problems in South Africa currently? You will find that the big problems when it gets to livestock theft is this bundle here in the Eastern Cape. You'll find that little bundle there up in KwaZulu-Natal. There's three stations here on the border between Free State, Lesotho, and KwaZulu-Natal. That's Bergville, Putita Chaba, and Harry Smith there. Then just to the north of Pretoria, you find this hotspot stations there. For the people familiar with the terrain and with the demographics, that's round about from KwaMashlanga to the old Lebuahomo area there. So that's about there. And then there's one here at the top is Sashego, just above Polokwane. We have the one here on the left in northwest, Mafeking. Big problem there. And then we have another one here at the bottom, which is the area around Taung. So if we can look at this a little bit more differently, as you will find that all these areas, as what we classify as high residential areas in rural areas. I mean, there's high populations of people in that particular areas, and that's why you have a lot of stock theft there. It's not, although there is in many of these areas, there are a lot of livestock. There's also a lot of people. So there's a correlation between the number of people, whatever. And if you go and take another graph and you put it on top of this one, which indicates poverty, you will find the direct relationship between poverty and livestock theft as well. So that's just for the interest of it. The next graph we're going to is the top five livestock hotspots per province. Looks a little bit different, but you still find this top ones here in the Eastern Cape. You still have that bunch there in KZN. Everything here above Pretoria, it's crazy. Up into Limpopo, as well as Mpumalanga. So you see that here you have a cluster of problems there between, from Pretoria north, you get the Temba area, and then from Temba, you go to the right, you go to Mpumalanga, and when you move up, you go into Limpopo. You see here the problems in the Northern Cape and the Free State, except for those two. You have another one there and another one there in the Free State. Then you have Mafeking there, you have Tahung there with its Pampierstad area. Then in the Northern Cape, you have this line here. And then you have this line coming down here in the Western Cape with their five top hotspot stations. But look carefully at the map. As you will see, there's main roads connecting them, especially in the north and the west. So another deduction we can make is that in this western part of the country here, we have about, or we don't have as much livestock theft as we have to the eastern part. So the more people, the more livestock, the more livestock theft. That's all this graph is telling. When you look, compare the number of stolen animals per 100,000 residents, be very, very careful and pay attention. This is 100,000 residents compared to the number of stock stolen. Then you will see, when we look at the number of animals stolen per 100,000 residents, you have the biggest problems this year in this purple area in Eastern Cape and KwaZulu-Natal. When it gets to cattle, you also have this little bit of a prevalence there, the green one there in Free State. And then we have the Limpopo one, which can become a problem. And then my biggest concern is Gauteng, where you have a lot of, per 100,000 residents, a lot of livestock stolen. But then you have here per 100,000 people, and you see, oh, that's also a problem. So just keep that in mind. But when you go to the, when you take, change your denominator and you move to the number of animals in the province, you see that per 100,000 animals, the biggest problem is in Gauteng. So of all the animals stolen per 100,000 for all the categories, cattle, sheep, and goats, the biggest concern and the biggest problem is in Gauteng. If you look at the hotspot stations in the previous, and it doesn't look that way. But if you just change the denominators, you see that the biggest concern and the biggest problem about livestock theft is in Gauteng. And then you see that the problems with the least problems is the Western Cape there at the top. You can just compare their statistics with the rest, and you see that it's really not actually comparable with the other ones. When we look at annual variations, this graph is also an interesting one. You will see the top one is sheep, but you will see here that about year from 2018, 2019, sheep theft is declining. Where it was always way around about 100,000, currently we're just above 90,000. So that there's a change there. So sheep theft is declining. The next line, the dotted one with this with this full line, that's cattle. And you see that cattle is following the same pattern as sheep. It's also declining. But what we remember, this is just to 2023. This is not 24. If I add the 24 statistics, you will see here that cattle theft is on the on an extreme rise. Sheep theft is on the extreme decline. But our biggest concern is that the theft of goats is becoming a big problem in South Africa. And if you go back to the previous charts, you will see that the big problems of goat theft is in the Taung area, the Mafeking area, in the Pilansberg area, and up in Sesheho. So that's where that's so, but we have a big rise here in goat theft. And if you look at KwaZulu-Natal, in that area as well, you see a big rise in goat theft. You don't see that in the Eastern Cape. That's all that statistics. I can bore you with this information for 2 days because I have everything of every province and I have the hotspots and I, but not to confuse you too much about what's going on in what province, whatever, as we have a big problem and we are losing around about 1.4 billion rand per year due to stock theft. That's what we're losing on average per year. And it's very strange because we have cattle, sheep, and goat, and the value of the animals differs extremely. So that in so sometimes when you have a rise in cattle theft, you see that it goes up, but it declines in sheep theft. The numbers come down. So we remain between 1.3, 1.4 billion on stock theft. When we get to the criminology theories and why stock theft happens and what is the reasons, what goes on? Is there any declaration for what's going on in this environment? In other words, look, we talk about environmental criminology theories, of which there are four. The one is routine activities theory, the one is crime pattern theory, the one is buffer zone, and the one is rational choice theory. I'm not going to go into these theories per se, but I will actually touch on a lot of the theories in the next couple of slides. Routine activities.